Welcome to my channel, Sunshine Shoulders. I'm Calvin. Thank y'all so much for stopping by again today. Are foreign men still a novelty in the Philippines? Absolutely. And that's not going to change anything anytime soon. It won't change in your lifetime. Where did I get this from? Well, one of my longtime followers makes the statement on a live stream. He says, off with city girls here in the Philippines, whatever city girls are here. So foreign men are no longer a novelty. They see them all the time, he says. It's no big deal. It's bullshit, man. Let me tell you something. Foreign men, foreigners, period, enjoy a celebrity status over here. It's the Philippines' number one tourist attraction. It's not Boracay. It's not Palawan or any of that other natural wonders that are over here. It's the fact that men know when they step off that plane, they're Keith Richards. Okay, it's the number one reason why we attract beautiful young women here who would normally be out of our league anywhere else under any other circumstances. So don't ever get it twisted. Foreign men are a big time novelty over here. It's not so much who we are, but what we represent. Let me remind you, because some of us either have forgotten or need to be reminded on a daily basis, that you represent financial freedom to a lot of women over here. And just because the internet is here, social media and Facebook means absolutely nothing. Because most people over here never even come in contact with a foreigner, especially a foreign man. I've never really met, let me see, I've met Rajon Rondo, I've met Daryl Griffith before. Dr. J when I was younger. The fact that I've done that, does that make NBA players less of a novelty? Absolutely not. More of a novelty. But yeah, guys, don't forget what you represent. You're literally a lottery ticket walking around here in some people's eyes. That's why you're always going to be a novelty. Diamonds are falling from the sky over here, and people know it. Let me tell you this, 45% of Filipino adults in 2023 have access to the internet. So don't ever think that all, just because you see foreigners here all the time, you see all these YouTube videos and all that, you're barely scratching the surface. I've been over here on and off for 15 years. I've been in San Carlos City 4.5 years, and the stares I still get. Because everybody here hasn't seen me. It's like the circus coming to town. This is good news for men. Okay, especially lonely men coming from the West. It's the reason we come over here. Because you know you're a novelty. Don't let some guy who, some Johnny come lately, convince you that you're not a novelty. Because you are. And when you get off the plane and you walk through that airport and you get out on the street, they're going to stare a hole through you. And it's going to be uncomfortable at first. But after a while, you'll come to be able to appreciate it for what it is. Because you're like a celebrity over here. They treat you like a celebrity. They're going to roll out that brightest red carpet I tell y'all about all the time. And you're going to enjoy privileges over here that you don't enjoy anywhere else. So stop with the nonsense about foreigners not being a novelty over here, because they absolutely are. You have women who will fight for your honor over here. What is a novelty? It's just something new, something unusual. And you are new. You're unusual to everybody that sees you over here. For the most part, even if you're in Manila, even if you're in Cebu, you're going to be a novelty. About 1 out of 10 Filipinos travel outside of their country. Okay, I got my nails and my, I had a pedicure and a manicure yesterday. And the manicurist, name is Jennifer. She's great, by the way. One of the best in the Philippines. I asked her just a simple question. Has she ever been to Manila before? Because me and Marilyn was having a conversation. She said, no. She said, sir, I've never even been to Cebu before. So imagine her saying that in 2023. She's in her early 30s. So you think that seeing a foreigner, seeing somebody like me is not a novelty? It absolutely is. We're still the best thing going over here. We're the Philippines. One of their most popular tourist attractions is the fact that you're a celebrity when you get over here. You're going to attract beautiful young women, man, that you wouldn't have a chance in hell of attracting in your country and in some of these other countries. And it's because you're a novelty. If you were not a novelty, people wouldn't want to take pictures with you everywhere you go. When Filipinos want to take a picture with you, you know what that means? That's like asking for your autograph. It's the same exact thing. So don't get it twisted. It's a good thing. It's not who we are. It's what we represent, guys, in the eyes of some of these people over here. Financial freedom. And because of that, you're always going to be a novelty. And that's not going to change. It's not going to change in my lifetime or yours. So thank you so much for stopping back. It's just a short video. Remember, I don't know what I'm going to talk about when I get up in the morning. But I thought this would be a good time to remind you of what you represent when you come over here. The royal flush. A new life. Okay, not only that, but Filipinos, they're just friendly. They love Western culture. So meeting you is like coming in contact with Western culture. They look at your shoes. They look at your clothes. They ask you questions about what's going on over there. Do you know Kobe Bryant? Yeah, right. I know Kobe Bryant. But it's because they're naive. They don't come in contact with foreigners on a daily basis. So if in America it's getting late, before you let your head hit the pillow, please find somebody to help. But if you don't want them late grocery runs, beer runs, weed runs, just getting off second shift, or you're on your lunch break, and you see somebody out in the street, or wherever you see them, buy them something to eat, buy them something to drink, give them a few dollars, if it's not going to put your life in jeopardy. If you're in the Philippines, it's early. It's not even 7 a.m., beautiful Saturday morning. We're going to do our spin wheel tonight. I'm going to have another round of Are You Smarter Than a Grade 5 Student today. I still help people over here, guys. I'm never going to stop doing that. But I do have to rein it in some. Because if I don't know anything else, I know this one thing for sure. When we help other people, we help ourselves. Take care. Stay safe. Stay out of trouble. I'll see you next time.